السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 2232 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Allah Jalla wa Ala, we focus on the 7th of Jumad al-Ukhra. The hadith is mentioned in Ibn Majah, an Anas radiallahu ta'ala an. Who is Anas radiallahu an? He was the khadim khas, the special attendant of the Master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam arrived in Medina Munawwara, it's obvious. So many people brought gifts, presents, but she, Umm Sulaym radiallahu anha, how intelligent. She brought her son, 10 years old. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the son of mine, he will be your khadim and your servant, and he will run your errands and so forth. So he states, Anna Nabiya sallallahu alaihi wasallam dakhala ala shabbin. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam entered on a youngster. Wahuwa fil maut. He was like in sakarat, his last stages. Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as time progressed, was so happy and elated, delighted with him, Anas bin Malik radiallahu an, and then said, Allahumma barik lahu fi ahlihi wa malihi. Ya Allah, give him barakah, blessing in his family and wealth. His harvest crops used to come twice a year. Some ulama wrote there was such fragrance emanating from them. Second one will be that his children give more and more. So children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, all put together over 100. Subhanallah. Faqal, Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw that this person is right now in his last stages. Kaifa tajiduka? How are you feeling? Qal, now the youngster replies, Arjullah, I'm remaining positive with Allah, Ya Rasulullah. So, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I'm positive. But same time, wa akhafu zunubi. Whilst I also fear I committed this sin and that sin and some vices or whatever it is. So remember that was. Now one side he has hope in Allah, one side fear. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was, is, will always be, the exclusive rahmatan lil alameen, mercy to the entire universe and creation, said, لَا يَجْتَمِعَانِ فِي قَلْبِ abdin. These two qualities do not combine in the heart of the true believer. Fi mithli hadhal mawtin, on this occasion here. Which occasion? When the person is a mihman, he's a guest now. Few minutes, few seconds, and then he'll leave the world. So on that circumstances, so then these two things don't combine. Illa a'atahu Allah ma yarju. But Allah gives him what he hopes, anticipates, and what he wants from Allah. Why? The Quran Sharif states, wa rahmati wasiat kulla shay. And my mercy, it encompasses and surrounds everything, broader, wider than everything. And hadith Qudsi, so many kitabs. You open Mishkat Sharif, Musnad Ahmad, all. وَأَنَا أَكُونُ عَلَىٰ ذُنِّ عَبْدِ بِي. I'll treat my servant as he thinks of me. So at that time there, so Allah will forgive him. Out of his mercy. وَآمَنَهُ مِمَّا يَخَافُ. Allah will grant him safety, security from what he fears, his sins and all that. So Allah will remove that, give him safety, security. So therefore me and you know, non-Muslims know, atheists know, death is inevitable. So always think about that and read chapter 3 verse 8. Allah keep us steadfast with iman, all times, all places, all circumstances. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma innaka antal wahhab. And Allah grant us death with iman, tawaffani muslima wa alhiqni bis salihin. Surah 12 verse 101. Amin ya rabbal alamin. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.